Welcome to our first video module on quantum mechanics. Today, we'll take a historical look at the life and times, the birth of quantum. Quantum came at the end of the modern or industrial era at a very special time in human history, going from roughly 1800 to 1920. The Civil War had just ended, and the First World War was still on the horizon. Relevant to your studies as physicists, Newton's discoveries have firmly taken hold in the field of mechanics. Chemistry was an evolving field with scientists developing the periodic table in complexity and comprehension. Related to this is the development of medicine as an actual scientific field, bringing with it things like penicillin and painkillers. Another leap in biology is the dawn of the theory of evolution under Darwin's inspiration. Most notably for this class, the laws of electricity and magnetism have been laid down by Maxwell, and scientists are now probing nature deeper than ever before. Most notably culturally, we see the dawn of engineering, as the understanding of how the nature world works enables profound new insights, ushering in a golden age of invention. The light bulb, the locomotive, the radio, the machine gun are but a small sampling of the new ideas from this era that effectively sculpt and build the foundations of the world as we know it. Science and technology plays a central role in humanity's experience during this era, characterized by humanity's mastery of the natural world. Almost all the questions that could be asked could be answered. In fact, some believe that humankind's knowledge could be absolute, that everything that could be known about the natural world was soon within our grasp. In the field of art and architecture, engineering enabled skyscrapers and more advanced elevators, subways, and other methods of transportation. French Impressionism was in full bloom. In literature, big hitters included The Origin of Species, Marx's philosophies on society, and Freud's theories on human behavior. Mathematics began to explore the field of statistics, as well as formalizing other mathematical fields. In addition, the power of calculus was being applied in the sciences. Put all this together, and the culture of the modernist era can be summed up with three central ideas. First, the promise and power of the scientific culture could be seen everywhere. Cities and nations could and were built at the hand of man. Second, industry and mass production brought new urban opportunities, redistribution of wealth, hence power to the common man. Finally, new society-based fields arose, such as economics, political science, and psychology. This truly was the golden age of man's conquest over nature, where anything that humankind had desired could be achieved. And in the early 1900s, that's how people saw the situation. But it wasn't all roses. Machine guns, deadly inventions, and new probes into nature were hinting at cracks in humanity's presumption, and hence in the modernist facade. One such crack is where we pick up the story, the photoelectric effect.